Hi everyone, my name is Audrey Vardaniga and I'm the Artistic Director of Musaics of the Bay. I'm delighted to present our 46th Stay at Home Symposium premiere featuring jazz pianist Kelly Green and double bassist Luca Soul Rosenfeld. Luca and Kelly are premiering a new piece for bass and piano inspired by Enrique Flores-Galbis' painting, Apophenia.
The painting, Apophenia, is part of a series of paintings which features a tightly woven thicket or bush where a tiger lurks well hidden. If you look real close, you might find the tip of the tail or an eye, and then the tiger emerges. As the series evolved in full view of the current events, the painted tiger disappeared, and the shapes and shadows in the foliage were left to suggest a threat that doesn't exist. Apophenia is a tendency to perceive meaningful connections between seemingly unrelated things and events. I came across this very important word in an article about the scientist who was asking a very big question. How did most of the tribes of the world come to believe that their scratchy, mostly inhospitable homes were created by an unseen presence, a god or gods? And why did they invest so much of their time, energy, and scant edibles on this somewhat abstract connection? The scientists guessed that before we could think about invisible gods in the clouds, we had to be able to see the tiger hiding in the bush. He told this little anecdote to explain this evolutionary advancement. A long, long time ago, two humans, we'll call them Ivy and Mum, were walking in the wilds. Suddenly, Ivy stopped and pointed at a dense thicket just ahead. "Stop, tiger," Ivy whispered. "What tiger?" Mum asked. "See that leaf, how it quivers," Ivy answered, pointing to the left. And then she pointed to the right. "See that cattail, how it shakes? Tiger." "Where you see this tiger?" Ivy pointed at the thicket again. "I see the tiger there." And then she pointed at her forehead. "And I see the tiger here." "I see no tiger. There is no tiger," Mum huffed, and then walked on down the trail and into the jaws of a very hungry wolf. Close enough, thought Ivy, as she hurried back home where she and her mate raised an army of boys and girls who had one trait in common. They all pointed at their forehead as they envisioned God, the wheel, fire, flight, jazz, and eventually empanadas. Today, this word, this evolutionary gift that helped the human family to rise, survive, and thrive, seems to have doubled back on itself to bite its own forked tail. But I've also witnessed gifted young musicians breathe into my painting, connect the disparate pieces, and then create a vivid temple where we can all go to meditate and hopefully visualize our way out of this thicket. I am hopeful, and we still have art. Thanks to all.
It was a tremendous honor to compose music for Apophenia by Enrique Flores-Galbis. From the start, we knew that we wanted to evoke a certain boldness and a certain lushness from the imagery of the jungle, and we wanted it to groove in an explicit way because of Henry's Cuban background.
Enrique graced us with his presence and explained a little bit about the piece to us, and it gave us ideas on how we wanted to approach the compositional aspect and how we wanted to develop the musical piece to accompany the visual. It was interesting to hear his approach on life and art, and specifically this piece.